technology is not new to any of us in any element of what we do in our working lives. From the finance function perspective, ERPs have been around for generations, it would seem, you know, hundreds of years, maybe not quite that far. But, you know, since computers have become viable for business and they're not taking up an entire room just for a floppy disk to be able to fit into a slot somewhere, you know, since they've been viable, people have been using technology to try and make their lives easier. And it's not new. We know from when we reach out to organisations that the vast majority of businesses have tried some sort of capture around accounts payable, whether it's been an in-house built program, whether it's a really basic sort of a scan capture piece that they can then just index it or type across, you know. But people have invested in technology, and especially organizations that have centralized processes or shared service centers which offer that to other parties. And that's where it's particularly seen, you know, if they've gone to the effort of centralizing a process, invariably they'll be using the technology to help with that, because they don't want to have to pay to have the person who lived in Cornwall that did their invoices to move to Manchester where their new center's going to be. And really, it's generally an easier way. But and what we say here is that and it's this idea that digital transformation is broader than just what it was maybe previously considered as, and yes, it's another name for technology we've been using, but it is a broader element, and we reference Uber here. So Uber was really interesting. Uber have not changed the way people use taxis. People still book a taxi, they get in the taxi, they pay the driver at the end, and they get out. They haven't changed that, but what they've done is they have changed the way in which we book our taxi. That's all they've done, and they've taken the human out of it. And that's the concept of digital transformation, taking the human element out and replacing it with a machine to give you the ability to deliver more benefit at lower cost because you've got lower overhead. And it's that concept, it's that structure that I think really is where, for us in our marketplace, we're trying to, you know, say to people, this is the why, you know. And it's not that you're going to fire people or whatever it may be, because these people are going to give you so much more value with the knowledge and the experience that they've gained in dealing with your suppliers, or, you know, whatever it may be that you move them towards, you know, the reporting, the analytics, all that kind
of stuff. It's the value add stuff. We've just finished earlier today, actually, we did another podcast, and we talked about the analytical side, the upskilling, the added value for employees. And I think you're right there, John. So the more that we move to sort of automation and technology, it's the upskill. You know, it's the elements of upskilling. It involves change, but you're right, spot on. Uber's a very good example of something. You know, it's like there's a lot of instances where there's no real asset other than change of process. And Uber's a classic example of using technology and automation of sorts, and a very successful business.